You're gonna have to leave. The bar is closed.
Closed? At this time of the day, Tim Sweeney would never allow this place to be closed at 3 o'clock in the afternoon.
My father died this morning.
What? Tim Sweeney dead? I can't believe it. He was a young man. He couldn't be more than 60.
Well, he was 55.
Ah, gee. Only 55. He looked good for 55.
Look, I hate to be rude, but the bar is closed.
Ah, of course, sir. You're Jack, right?
Yes.
Tom Bender. Elbow. That's what your father called me. Every time I walked through that door. Funny man. Ah, geez, he talked a lot about you all the time. Jack put this one away, Jack put that one away. Jack was in the papers again. It's funny we never met. I was beginning to think you were a figment of his imagination until I saw you on the news this morning. That was you, wasn't it?
In a very ill-timed press conference, yes.
What office are you running for?
I'm running for Congress.
Ah, Jesus, I knew it was you. You think you did it on purpose?
You know, we have a lot of arrangements to make. I really would like you to leave.
I guess he thought he'd win you the sympathy vote.
More like he thought he'd steal my thunder. Sir, could you please just go?
I still can't believe. Your father was a great man. He did right by me. I owe him a lot, a whole lot. He got me out of a sticky situation.
Look,
I swore to pay him back, but...
Don't worry about it. As a matter of fact, just forget it.
I will not forget it. Your father was a decent man. I wouldn't feel right.
Look, whatever was between you and he, let's just say it died with him.
I'd say no such a thing. I know I can't repay him for everything he's done for me, but the least I can do is pay you the money that I owe him. Takes money to get into office, don't it?
Whatever you say.
Well, glad to meet you, Jack. Wish it was different circumstances.
Thanks,
Elbow! Oh. Elbow Bender, you know. Your father was a great man. Funny as hell. A man you could trust. Jeez, I'm gonna miss that bastard. Ah, who am I talking to? You're gonna miss him more than anybody. You've been his pride and joy and all. He wouldn't mind just one last buyback. Here's to you, Tim Sweeney, and may you rest in peace. I'll have that money for you before he's buried.
Wouldn't count on it.
Oh,
I just thought those were not right. Jack!
Colleen.
Do I not exist?
Of course, Teresa. How are you?
I made some meatballs if you like, Jack.
No, thanks. I'm good. So, where's TJ?
Oh, he'll turn up.
Do you mean he doesn't know yet?
We beeped him, but he never called back.
What an irresponsible...
It's not his fault. I found his beeper in the couch.
You didn't tell me that.
I didn't want you to worry.
But you tell Jack as soon as he walks through the door?
This is just great. What a selfish, spoiled... Just like his father. So when was the last time anyone heard from him?
He was here Tuesday when I left for the hospital.
Talking about it is not going to bring him back. Come on, Teresa. Let's start the collage before the others get here.
What others?
I told you. Ellen's coming to help with the arrangements.
Ellen and who else? She's not coming, is she?
I wish we had a picture of Daddy as a child, don't you, Teresa?
She is not coming in here. I forbid it.
Teresa, do you hear something?
No. I like this one.
Oh, that tie. He looks like Fred Flintstone.
Where's that one of him and Frank from the barbecue?
You think you're being funny, but I am serious. She is not coming in here.
That was an awful picture. Daddy looked like hell.
Did he? Well, Frank looked good. Here it is. Daddy doesn't look that bad.
No picture of Frank Tully is going in, and none of her either.
Jack, she has a name, and whether you like it or not, she did live with him for the last 10 years of his life.
And Frank is family, practically. Don't you think you should go in, Tommy?
After what he pulled?
God, you make such a big deal.
Missing your father's wake is a big deal.
Frank's not coming to the wake?
He had to go out of town.
Yeah, for a Mets game.
It's not just a Mets game, it's tradition. Every year, he and his friends go to a different city.
Yeah, this year it's San Diego.
Yeah, that's different.
He would have stayed if I wanted him to. He was worried about me. He even got me something for my nose. Wasn't that thoughtful?
Oh, you're not gonna start popping pills, I hope.
Oh, sorry about that.
Well, welcome to the Jerry Springer Show.
Oh, save the melodrama for the courtroom, Jack.
I'm not being melodramatic. I'm serious. I have a reputation to uphold, and I can't have...
Well, I have a reputation. I'm sick of hearing about your... What are you doing here, anyway? You haven't been here since Mommy died.
We tried to reach you, TJ.
Yeah, but you were too busy doing God knows what with God knows who to be around when your father died.
Don't even start with that, Jack. I didn't see you at the hospital.
I had important reasons for my absence. TJ, come on. It's not even 3 p.m. and you already bombed. Don't you know when to stop?
What could be more important than your own father dying?
If I came running every time that you had him at death's door.
He was at death's door, Jack.
Now, how was I supposed to know that?
And they say we're the immature ones.
I told you the doctor said his liver was failing.
His liver was failing. And that was what, only the 6th time they said that?
Well, don't you think that maybe it was worth the inconvenience to come and see him, just in case?
It wasn't a matter of inconvenience, Colleen. You don't know what I've been working on.
Is that a dig because I don't have a career?
What?
I'll have you know, I want to stay home and raise my children.
Pathetic, aren't they?
What I do is just as important as prosecuting criminals.
I never said that it wasn't.
Oh. Hi, Ellen.
I was about to tell you something that concerns us all.
Thanks for the house call.
Please, it's a pleasure. I still consider your mother's departure packet to be one of my crowning achievements.
Oh, it was nice, wasn't it?
Like a dream. But believe it or not, I have some idea for your father's arrangements that might even top what you did for her. Shall we get started?
Well, I kind of told Debbie we'd wait for her.
Debbie? I don't recall working with a Debbie. Is she a cousin? Aunt?
A slut, tramp, bimbo, E, all of the above?
Oh, grow up, Jack.
Oh, she's your father's, Is there anything you want to tell me before she gets here?
Not really. She's being very cooperative.
I have something to say.
Jack always has something to say.
Maybe you'll understand, Helen. No one in this family cares to think about anyone but themselves.
Huh, look who's talking.
I have a vested interest in making my father send off as dignified as possible.
Well, I'm confident we can do that.
Good. Because it's imperative that we don't have any public drunkenness, no wailing mistresses throwing herself on the coffin, and no bums like,
Elbow?
Yeah.
Oh, he's harmless.
I don't care. No bums are coming to this wake.
But he was Daddy's friend.
Yeah, one of the more refined ones at that.
I don't care if the guy was the Pope. I can't afford any public embarrassment.
You can't afford? Since when is Daddy's wake about you anyway?
Don't you see, TJ? It's not about me. It's bigger than me. Today, I announced that I am running for Congress. And a lot of important people are counting on me to represent the party. I can't have a bunch of white trash showing up and dragging me down.
Yeah, but they'll be your constituency.
Have another drink, TJ. You're not slurring enough yet.
Don't mind if I do.
You see, the thing is, I won't even have a constituency if I don't get enough campaign funding. Campaign dollars don't exactly come from the type of losers that Daddy surrounded himself with. I can't have the people with the checkbooks.
Seeing where you came from, Jack? You know, you wouldn't even have political aspirations if it weren't for Daddy. He's the one who put you on that path.
Absolutely not. Anything that I have ever accomplished, I did on my own. The only thing that man ever did was get in my way. Case in point, he even picked the worst possible time to die.
Is there a good time to die?
I don't want to drink to that much.
It's because I don't come from a better family that this is it for me. Make or break. The party's only going to give me one chance, and that's because of the good press that I got from the Taylor trial. I blow this and it's over, and I refuse to let that happen.
Well, I'll do everything I can to ensure that things run smoothly, but there are, unfortunately, limitations to the amount of control that I have. If someone wants to pay respects to Tim, there's very little we can do to stop them.
Sorry, Jack. Looks like Debbie will be throwing herself on the coffin after all.
Where is she, anyway? I told her 3 o'clock.
Look, I'm gonna go put my things upstairs. If she's not back by the time I return, we lock the doors and we start without her. And under no circumstances does she find out that I'm running for office. She will sabotage me.
Oh, don't be ridiculous. What does she have to gain by doing that?
I don't know. But she'll find something, trust me.
That's good, Jack. You've been a politician one day, and you already got the paranoia to trust me down.
Have another drink, TJ.
So, I hear you're moving upstate.
Don't believe everything you hear.
I'm sorry, did things not work out?
No, everything is fine. It's just with Daddy's dying and Jack's announcement, I just don't know if the timing is right.
She says it's bad timing. Baloney. She's afraid she won't be able to run my life from upstate.
That's not true, Teresa. You're drunk. Oh, I'm sorry we're late, but Charlie insisted on escorting me here. Though I was totally capable of handling this on my own.
Nothing wrong with a fella giving his sister a little moral support, is there?
No, not as long as it's of the silent variety.
Well, Debbie, this is Ellen. She's the one who did my mother's funeral. Ellen, Debbie, my father's friend. Charlie, Ellen, Charlie, you know everyone else.
I guess Jack considers himself too important to be here. I caught that press conference this morning.
Well, the cat's out of that bag.
No, that's okay. Jack is here. He just ran upstairs.
This seat. Now they'll think you owe them one.
Charlie, shut up.
I thought we'd begin with the coffin. This is the one you selected for your mother. An excellent choice. Its male counterpart is the Eternal Reward 6000 in walnut. I'd suggest the ivory liner instead of the rose tint. It's more masculine. Of course, the beige is another handsome option.
TJ, are you going to join us?
Leave him alone. He's bombed.
Fine, then I won't tell you Daddy's a millionaire.
What? It
says right here, you may have already won $10 million.
Give me the mail before you barf on it.
Which will it be, ivory or beige?
Ivory. Beige. Teresa, what do you think?
Whichever one doesn't clash with his jaundice.
She asked me, Jack, not you.
Maybe this will help. What color suit is he wearing?
Brown.
Oh. Well, perhaps if we start with another topic. Oh, a very important issue. Because Tim died on Thursday and the church doesn't allow funerals on Sunday, you can either have the wake on Friday and the funeral Saturday, or you can have a 3-day wake with the funeral on Monday. Oh, but Colleen, you're closing on the house on Monday.
Since when are you buying a house?
Can we not talk about that now?
I told you.
Your decision?
Wake him Friday, bury him on Saturday.
What, so fast? He's got so many friends. What if they can't make it?
If they can't make it, then screw them.
If it's 3-day, Frank will be back.
Oh, screw Frank. 1-day wait.
If that's settled, let's go on to the next item, transportation. As you know, it's customary for the bereaved to take a limousine to both the funeral and the cemetery.
How many people does this limo fit?
Doesn't matter, because it fits blood relations only. You outsiders will have to find your own way.
Hey, how do you know my sister is not an outsider? Why, she and Tim got...
Charlie!
Why can't I tell him? I'd kill to see his face.
I am warning you.
You could always hire 2 limos.
We'll do that, then.
But that'll be an additional charge.
That'll be fine.
If there are no objections, we'll continue. Okay, there have been some exciting developments recently. In the Chronicle...
Sorry.
Of the immediate bereavement period.
Colleen, where did Daddy keep the financial papers?
It was pretty disorganized. Debbie would know best.
You don't have to tell him. If he'd been around enough, he'd know where the papers are.
Where are
Charlie,
the papers?
Charlie, you stay out of this.
Where are the goddamn papers?
Don't tell him.
Why not? I have nothing to hide.
They're behind the bar in the file box.
Our video packages range from the most cost-effective memories package to more elaborate reminiscences.
Video packages?
Well, Tim was very photogenic.
Is this a funeral or a bar mitzvah?
I'm sorry, Ellen, but that sounds a bit ghoulish to me.
Sounds expensive, too, to me.
Well, I don't know. I think Debbie can handle it.
Me? I don't have any money.
Oh, no? Then what about this $20,000 you took out of his bank account last month?
What? I did not take any money out of that account.
Yeah, then who did?
Running a political campaign ain't exactly cheap.
Oh, don't be ridiculous. Jack didn't know the account number.
So you did. Did I hear you say you were buying a house?
Are you accusing my sister of stealing?
You got some kind of confession to make?
Excuse me. You can't just come in here making accusations
like
that.
Who's gonna stop me?
Excuse me. I'm gonna stop
you. You can't let it drop.
Now, sit down. Let's proceed.
Oh my God, Teresa. I really thought they were going to come to blows, didn't you? Teresa? Oh my God, TJ, call 911.
She's just dropped.
No, I think she took some pills.
She's still breathing.
This family is unbelievable.
Yes, hello. I need an ambulance right away. Oh, I'll hold.
My chance to wake up.
No. So, Ellen, tell us about your 2-for-1 specials.
He had. So which one do you think?
Well, does Bob know he's losing a tie?
Why would he be losing? I didn't think about that. Well, better go with this one. Bob's mother gave him this one for Christmas. While I was in the closet, I picked up out something for you.
I'm not wearing your husband's clothes. I'm wearing this.
Oh, Daddy's sports jacket. Mommy got him that before they were married.
You think it'll pass muster with Jack's finance committee?
Well, the sleeves are a bit short, but wear it. You're really gonna miss him, aren't you?
Let's not over-sentimentalize here. I didn't have anything else to wear anyway. I'm saving my suit for tomorrow.
You've already got your wardrobe chosen for tomorrow? I thought I'd have to drag you out of bed when I got here.
Yeah, well, it's kind of hard to sleep with a hatchet in your skull.
Well, it serves you right. You were trashed last night.
Look, I don't need a lecture, all right? I'll take some aspirin if you have any.
Here you go.
Oh, yes. Thank God.
Drinking killed Daddy, you know.
Yeah, well, worrying killed Mommy, right? You happy?
Well, it's a start.
Look. I'm not looking forward to remaining sober while Jack reinvents Daddy for his own political gain. I mean, the voters should know what a hypocrite he is. They should know he refused to speak to his father for the last 10 years. But no! He'll only let them see the dutiful morning sun.
Well, it was hard on Jack when Daddy moved in with Debbie.
Oh, the rest of us were able to forgive him. Even Mommy forgave him better than Jack. I mean, you would think he was the scorned lover.
Jack's always been obsessed with living by the rules. On my 6th birthday, going to the Bronx Zoo, Mommy told me to duck under the turnstile. Jack started screaming, "You can't do that! She's 6! You have to pay!" Do you know, Mommy tried to shush him, but he walked right up to the token booth clerk and ratted her out. God, she was so upset. She couldn't afford to buy us cotton candy because of that.
That's the thing. He likes to think he's acting for the greater good, but he just does it to get attention.
I hate you, Jack. You did it on purpose. You know I have to work with those people.
people.
The doctor asked me if I had questions. I had questions.
He asked you for pamphlets on suicide prevention and substance abuse. It was so embarrassing. He acted like I was some sort of suicidal addict or something.
Yeah, well, you should have thought of that before you overdosed.
It was an accident.
Look, I do not have time to argue with you. I mean, it's bad enough that I have these bags under my eyes from spending the whole night in the emergency room. At least now I can go shower and shave.
You can't go in the shower now. I am.
Well, then hurry up.
Are you in a hurry to begin mourning?
I'm in a hurry to get my hands on the deed to this place. There's no sign of it in here. You know, she may have managed to siphon 20 grand from his bank account, but she is not scamming ownership of this place. The deed has to be somewhere in her apartment. Hey, Colleen. Colleen, do me a favor. Call her up and ask her to bring it to the wake.
I'm not doing that. I'm not looking to make a profit off his death.
A profit? Is that what you think? Come on, this is no profit. This is payback. Payback for every Little League game he missed, for every school play he couldn't show up for because some drunk needed a listening ear and a fifth of bourbon. If you don't think that his own flesh and blood, the very flesh and blood that he shacked with in life, aren't entitled to it more than some bimbo shacked up with, I have no idea what would make you happy. What?
That's the only thing his father left him. What makes you think you deserve more?
You bought that whole Irish Marnie bit lock, stock, and barrel, didn't you? You want to be able to say how Daddy had to walk 6 miles to school uphill in the snow both ways in the bare feet. Not me. No way. I'm sorry. This is America. And some romantic tale about a cat being the only thing a dying man leaves with a dirty son is not going to cut it. No, sorry, not with me. In this country, people work hard so that when they do die, they have more than a bunch of stories to leave their kids about how the world did them wrong. If neither of you want what is rightfully yours, I will gladly take your share. But that man, he owes me.
I'm Sandy, the worker. I'm sorry about you in like this, but I heard the news about him. You see, my fiance, Eddie, he worked with him. He's a nice man. He gave Eddie a chance. You see, my fiance, he doesn't get along too well with people. He gets frustrated easily. But with Tim, they never had any problems. Working here has been good for Eddie. He feels good about making steady income. 2 months ago, we had a baby, and to your father, I'm thankful. I made some lasagna for your family. I hope you like it.
Oh, thank you. I'm sure we will. Please come sit.
TJ, were there any call messages?
Who did Frank call?
Did he?
No.
Are you sure I called from the hospital to his hotel?
You think he's gonna call just because you had a near-death experience?
I should try him again. He probably didn't get the message.
Teresa, this is Sandy. She made us lasagna. Wasn't that nice?
Yeah.
Teresa just loves lasagna.
Oh yeah, almost as much as she loves being dissed by her fiancé.
It's not that. If he got the message, he'd be worried for nothing.
If he were worried about you, he wouldn't have left town the day your father died.
You engaged too? Since Valentine's Day. You want to see my ring?
Wow, that's something.
At least some people can appreciate Frank.
Yeah, if only Frank would appreciate you.
I wish you would all quit trying to run my life.
He's not trying to run your life.
Yes, he is. So are you. I may not be perfect like you, but I have a mind of my own.
I never said I was perfect.
You don't have to. Everybody knows it. She thinks just because she has kids who go to bed on time and a husband who does dishes, everybody should be like her. Look, she even knows what accessories to wear to a wake. Have you ever seen anyone so well coordinated all your life?
Teresa, if you want the necklace, you can have it. There is no reason to drag poor Sandy into this.
This may not be my place, but it is a nice necklace.
Oh, now you're turning strange against me.
Look, I'm going to go put the lasagna in the fridge. It's getting kind of hot in here.
I'm not turning anyone against you.
And I'm not against anybody. I just came here to give you some lasagna. Maybe I better go.
No, you have to hear my side of the story first. Colleen will tell you that everything I ever have to do in life, she feels she needs to taught me.
That's not true.
It is. When I graduated from grammar school, she graduated from high school. I graduated from high school, she got married. I finally thought I had her beat when I graduated from college. And you know what she did next?
Oh, you're not going there again.
She gave birth on my graduation day.
She acts as if I could have planned these things.
Huh, I'm not so sure you didn't.
Behold, for before you stands the master. Oh, you should have seen it. It was great. They had no idea what hit him.
What are you talking about, Jack?
What's in the box?
I had no idea what I was so afraid of. I mean, the tramp and his stupid friend. They're too stupid to pull anything over on the master. So who's this?
This is Sandy. Her fiancé works here.
Eddie, he mops up boxes empties. For what he gets paid, it's not much, but Tim was generous. I think he understood Eddie.
I am so glad that you are here. You can tell Eddie that we don't need him anymore. The bar is closed until further notice. Now please, if you'll excuse us, we have some family business to attend to. Thank you very much. Bye.
You are so rude. She made us lasagna.
So what? Who was she anyway?
Well, who are you to treat anyone like that?
Don't you know? Only the people who contributed to Jack's campaign earn his respect.
Well, what do you know? And what are you wearing? You're not going to wear that jacket to the wake, are you?
Oh, look! My butterfly from kindergarten!
Come on, leave that stuff alone until I get the deed, all right?
Hey, T. You know that total point made from paper towel rolls?
Jack, what is all that stuff?
Well, the tramp said the deed must be in this box amongst his stuff, so I took it.
The whole box?
Right under her nose?
I'm the master! I tell you, once we find this deed, it's gonna be great. I can sell this place, and then she is out of our lives forever.
You can't just decide to sell this place.
Why not? I'm the firstborn son.
What happened to your neck?
Oh, it's nothing. Just a little sprain from the altercation last night. The doctor advised this just as a precaution.
Oh my God, they hurt you?
Oh really, it's nothing. All a part of the profession.
I'm sorry.
No, don't touch me! I just came by to drop off these death certificates. There are 5 originals here. They'll serve you in any situation in which you have to prove your father is dead. Any transfer of titles, life insurance, savings account, things of that nature.
I am taking these.
Of course you will.
Now why shouldn't I?
Now I'll be running along. I'll see you in an hour then.
Great, Jack. Now you're frightening everyone away.
A heck of a public servant, isn't he?
Hey, I was looking at that.
Nobody takes anything from this box until I find the deed. But right now I've got to go get ready.
You can't go in the shower. I have to go dry my hair.
What the hell?
I am not looking forward to this wake.
Yeah, neither am I. Uh-oh, it's worse than you think.
Oh no, what?
Ellen forgot the time. Just
oh my God!
Oh,
and now we'll have a moment with the repulsive soul of Timothy Sweeney.
And all you could hear was, you stupid bastard, I'll kick your ass!
Oh my God, I thought I was gonna wet my pants.
I think Father Rafferty did.
He tried praying louder than the commotion, but by the time he reached the glory bee, half the crowd was outside.
Ow, every time I laugh, my lip bleeds.
Yeah, well, that's what you get for stopping a punch with your face.
Oh, look who's talking.
Hey, I was holding my own until that big goon had to jump in. Man, who was he anyway?
I don't know, his partner, I guess.
Yeah, that's New York's finest for you, huh? Nothing better to do than to start a fight in a week.
You're lucky he didn't shoot you, Jack.
I mean, the nerve of that guy telling me it was disrespectful to have pictures of Mom at Dad's wake.
Yeah, he should have minded his own business.
He was only looking out for his sister. You'd do the same for me.
That's enough with the empathy, Colleen. The tramp and his stupid brother are nothing but trash.
Oh, and brawling in front of a funeral home makes you a role model of civility?
You see, I knew something like this was going to happen.
Well, things might not have gone exactly as you planned, Jack, but I think Tim would have been pleased. His 2 sons banding together to defend their mother's honor, I think he would have been proud.
Definitely. Daddy definitely would have thought it was cool. The whole thing. I mean, really, a little brawling, a lot of laughter.
And so many people.
Yeah, I didn't know half of them. Who are those 2 old ladies in the back? They stayed the whole time.
Do you mean the church ladies? Oh, come on, they never miss a wake.
No, I spoke to them. They lived on Daddy and Debbie's block. Do you know that Daddy took out the garbage for them every week?
They're senile. They had to be at the wrong place.
Why do you find it so hard to believe that he did something nice for someone?
Aside from the fact that he never did anything nice for us?
I heard a lot of people saying a lot of nice things about Daddy.
Me too. Larry O'Malley said he used to drive him up to Westchester to see his wife in the home.
That's right. He also sponsored a girls' basketball team at St. Anthony's. Did anyone know that?
Well, he was just a goddamn saint then, wasn't he? Are you people so naive you don't even know what you're hearing? Let me spell it out for you, TJ. Daddy was a bar person. These were bar people. Of course they're going to tell you he was the greatest. Of course they're going to jump on the bandwagon of death because then maybe, just maybe, if they play their cards right, we'll invite them back here for a couple of free drinks.
You think so?
Jack thinks everyone has an ulterior motive, just like he does.
Yeah, well, right now my only motive is to get the deed to this place and unload it fast. This way those leeches can suck up to somebody else for a change.
Put down that box and come over here. I'm sorry, Colleen. I said sit. Now, I can't account for those people at the wake tonight, but I can tell you this much. The Tim Sweeney I knew, he was far from a saint, but he was a generous man with a big heart. And whenever I came in here after dealing with those greedy, self-centered punks like you, he always had a warm smile and a corny joke for me. Now, I don't know what kind of baggage you're carrying around. Quite frankly, I don't care. But you need to get rid of that chip, Sonny, and show some respect. You lost a very special man. And if you need someone to point that out to you, I'll be glad to do so. But I won't put up with your superior attitude any longer. I'm sorry for the lapse in professionalism, Colleen. This has been most difficult.
What? She was just another bar person.
Oh, come on.
Ellen is right. We did lose a very special person, and it's about time we took note of that.
Jeez.
Is that Niagara Falls, Colleen? Did you know they went to Niagara Falls?
Who?
Mommy and Daddy.
Did they?
Looks like it.
They look so young. It must have been their honeymoon.
I see. I thought they went to Florida for their honeymoon.
Well, which was it? Florida, Niagara Falls? How do we ever know these things anymore? About them. And about us. I mean, I never thought of that before. When they told us stories about how they met and growing up, I listened. But I never really listened. I always thought they'd be here.
Oh.
Colleen, we'll be able to dance at my wedding.
Oh, that's okay.
Who's gonna give me away?
Oh, well, Jack can give you away. Or TJ. That's okay.
Hey, check it out, Teresa. Looks like Daddy kept some kind of journal or something. You know, I bet you he wrote down some of those stories you want to hear about.
You think so?
Sure.
I wonder what else he kept.
Oh, look, Teresa! Your first trophy for Irish dancing.
I can't believe he kept that. That was the day he was at Gaelic Park on the subway.
Wait a minute, Daddy took you to a fesh?
Maybe if you stopped sitting there sulking like a child, you'd learn something about your father.
I know all I need to know about that man, thank you very much. Except for where he kept the deed.
Hello? Yes? Hold on a minute. Jack, it's that guy Baxter from the video show. He wants to know if you and Charlie were fighting over who gets kickbacks if you get elected.
Tell Baxter to go scratch himself.
Jack says no comment.
Thanks, Colleen. That guy's a real pain in the ass. I'd hate to have to be on the bad side.
All right. Baxter says you can speak to him now, or you can talk to all the local reporters in the morning.
Yeah, like he wishes he had such influences.
Jack says no comment. Yes. Okay. All right. Baxter says he'll speak to you in the morning if the vultures haven't eaten you alive.
You know, even if he could manage to get anyone from the press to show up, I'd find some sort of way to turn it into my advantage. Colleen, just turn off that phone right now. I don't want any more interruptions. Can't they see we're in mourning?
Is that what you're doing? I thought you were running a campaign.
Well, I was trying to until Daddy had to go screw things up. I mean, look at that. Even from the beyond the grave, he gets in my way.
Aren't you overreacting?
Yeah, he's not even in the grave yet.
I'm not so sure things will be any different once he is.
I don't get it, Jeff. I just don't get it. I try to understand. I try to be sympathetic and see your point of view. But why? Why do you hate him so much? He was your father!
He was my father? He was my father. Okay, then how come How come the man spent more time planning fundraisers for children of falling firefighters than he did playing catch with me? And how come, okay, all right, how come he spent 2 years, 2 years on a committee deciding whether or not a stop sign should go in front of the school, but never one time did he step foot in that building? Not to meet one of my teachers, not to see a science fair project that he should have helped me build.
Well, maybe he didn't do those things, but he did other things for you.
Like what?
Well, he put a roof over your head. He sent you to private school. He taught you how to play the piano, Little League.
A freaking sponsor of Save the Children could have done any of those things.
Well, he did the best he could. Quite frankly, I don't know what he could have done to make you happy.
Oh, I think I do. It's not about the science projects, Jack, is it? It's not about playing catch. It's not even about him disgracing the family and moving in with Debbie, is it, Jack?
What are you talking about?
It makes perfect sense. Now that I think about it, I can't believe I missed it.
Missed what?
Should I tell him, Jack, or should you? No, wait, I will, Jack. I'd hate to pass up an opportunity like this. Doesn't come along every day.
TJ, spill it.
Jack, you had an affair with Debbie before Daddy ever met her.
What?
Yep. So the reason why Jack hates Daddy, the reason why he didn't speak to him for the last 10 years is that Jack was mad because Daddy took his girlfriend.
Is that true?
Hey, how you doing there?
Come on.
Just do you mind if I have a word with you? This won't take but a minute.
Did you see that we're in the middle of something here?
I hate to interrupt, but is it a matter of the money we discussed? I ran into a minor problem. Minor! I'll have it for you.
Look, I told you before, I do not want your stupid money.
But I told you I'd get it and have it first thing in the morning, I swear.
Fine. Then, could you just go now?
I'm leaving, but I'll be back.
Hey, Elbow. Here. This should save you the trip.
Huh?
Goodbye, Elbow. Okay, fine, so I went out with her. What was I supposed to know? I was 19.
Ew, you went out with her too? What do you people see in her?
I was just a stupid kid. But my supposed father, my supposedly married father, he should have known better.
Oh my God, I don't believe it. Now what?
It's Charlie. McCann, what are you doing here?
We had a report from the proprietors of this establishment that there were intruders on the premises.
Charlie, what are you talking about? We both know that the proprietor of this establishment is dead. We nearly beat each other's brains out over it, remember?
Yes, I remember, but don't try it again. I have 2 squad cars outside. If you don't remove yourselves from the premises, I'll have you removed. For breaking and entering.
What?
Oh my God, we're gonna be arrested?
For breaking and entering your own father's bar?
Charlie, you can't pull this crap. I know about these things, and you're gonna get yourself in a lot of trouble.
This bar was no longer your father's. I have the paperwork to prove it.
What paperwork?
The bar wasn't my father's, and whose was it?
Mrs. Timothy J. Sweeney.
My mother's been dead for 2 years.
Not the late Mrs. Sweeney. The new one. My sister, Debbie. I'm sorry that you weren't invited to the wedding. It was an exclusive affair. No outsiders were invited.
Oh my God, he married her?
That says a week ago. It can't be.
It was. So if you don't remove yourselves from the premises, I'll have you removed. In cuffs.
There's no way this happened.
It's all there in black and white, Colleen. Just calm down.
But it's fake. It has to be.
Daddy signed the place over to his new bride. Let's not give Charlie a hard time.
His new bride? Are you crazy? A week ago, he couldn't sign anything. He was nearly comatose.
She's right. He was really bad.
Well, obviously, he was well enough to get married. Now, it's been a long day, and I'm sure Charlie wants to go.
Charlie wants? I don't know what you think you're doing, but you are going to leave
me! Please,
people are crazy. Now you got girls attacking me.
I'm sorry, man. She's a little tightly wound. TJ, get her some water.
But Jack, they took advantage of me. It was so helpless.
So they got married, huh? you know, sorry, but we didn't know. I mean, I guess it's great that they were able to before, you know.
What the hell are you talking about?
GJ, just shut up, okay? I'm handling this. Sorry, man, we had no idea.
Just doing what I have to do.
I understand. I guess, welcome to the family.
I guess we are kind of family. Look, I'm sorry for busting in.
No, I understand. Just doing what you had to do.
I can do this two ways, easy or hard. Just don't forget who owns the bar. Bury your father, take care of your affairs, and I'll see you in the morning.
All right, see you then.
Those papers were forged, Jack!
Don't you think I know that? Did you see who married them? Reverend Patrick Dwyer, Patty Dwyer, their nerdy cousin?
If you knew they were phony, why were you kissing up to him?
Because he's a politician, remember? Kiss first, think later.
The last thing that I need is to be locked up by Charlie for some bogus charge. He'd do it too, the psycho. Don't worry, I'm gonna take care of them. We're gonna get this bar back.
The bar? Forget about the bar, Jack. There's no way he married her. All he was capable of doing last week was sucking water from a sponge and roaring in agony when the nurses changed his bloody bed sheets. Forget the bar. They stole his dignity, Jack. Can you get that back?
I can get them jail time. I can guarantee that. I mean, how stupid can they be? Flashing forged documents in my face.
Hey, what do you make of all of this?
Yes, Mark Kowalski, please.
What difference does it make what I make of anything? I mean, Jack is turning this into anything but what it should be. He wants to get votes out of this, or revenge on Debbie, or the bar. Daddy's dead. We'll never see him again. Never. I don't know. I mean, has that something to any of you?
Yeah, Kowalski, Jack Sweeney. Yeah, listen, I need your advice on a suspected fraud/forgery case. No, I'm not going to be able to try it myself, but I can gather you all the evidence.
There's no way he married her.
Oh, how do you know that, Colleen?
Because everybody tells me everything. It's what I do.
Oh, yeah, like how Jack told you he went out with Debbie?
Well, maybe I didn't know about that. But that just proves my point. Without me, you guys don't know what to do with yourselves.
And she tells me she doesn't try to run my life. Hey, what's this? Maybe he left an audio will.
Yeah, right. Or directions to his buried treasure.
That sounds familiar. Who is it?
That's us.
Who us?
Us. That's right. Daddy made that tape when I didn't exit when I dragged us out of bed to play for him. Don't you remember?
Yeah, some record producer stopped by to use the phone. And the next thing you know...
Daddy had him all licking up when we were playing for him.
And we made this tape.
The guy with the boots? Snakeskin boots, I do remember. He gave me $1.
Yeah. Pig Mike Moran gave me a silver dollar once, too. I think I still have it. Lots of people used to give us money.
And chips. And quarters from Pac-Man.
I had my initials in all the high score spots, if I do say so myself.
I used to be mortified performing in front of all those people. But in retrospect, I guess it was kind of fun. Boy, we don't sound that bad. Come on, Teresa. You're the dancer in the family.
No way. In these shoes?
What could make someone so young be such an old fart?
Uh-oh. Woo! Go, girls!
Yeah!
Oh! Go, girls!
Yeah!
No, wait, I don't dance! I don't dance!
Oh,
I'm a klutz, oh god! I'm a klutz! Klutz!
The hell is the people! I am on the phone trying to win back your inheritance. I'm doing something for your benefit. And you're carrying on like a bunch of ignorant nicks. Why do I even extend myself to you people?
Oh, God!
Mix,
where'd
you get that one?
I told you it was a bad idea for me to dance.
God. You think it could be fixed?
He's worried about our inheritance. He just destroyed a piece of it. He charges Debbie with the fraud. He's the fraud. I don't want to have nothing to do with it from this day forward.
You can't do that, TJ. He's your brother.
So I'll be a brother to him, like he was a son to Dad.
Two wrongs don't make a right.
I mean nothing to him. Nobody means anything to him. None of us do, unless he could use it for something.
And you don't think he's miserable being like that?
Oh, he's a self-centered son of a bitch. He deserves misery.
No, he doesn't, Tej. No one does. He's not a bad person. He's just lost. He spent so long striving to be looked up to by others that he just forgot how to be himself. Now maybe we can't help him get that back, but we should stick around for him in the meanwhile.
Colleen, your sympathy knows no bounds, but you'd be better off if it did. I mean, you'd get to start fresh with Bob and the kids, a whole new world, a new house, and you want to stay here to raise your own siblings? You should get away from here. Run away. Do it while you can. And only look back only if you want to, not because you feel you have to.
Frank? Oh, hi, Bob. Bob.
Hi, honey. What's up? You told him what? No, I'm not blaming you. Just put him on. Hi, Andrew, sweetie. It's Mommy. What's the matter, baby? Oh, that's not true. Dying is not like sleeping forever. When you sleep, you have sweet dreams, and your body is resting. But when you die, your body is broken, and the doctors can't fix it. That's right, baby. Your body's not broken, but Grampy's was, and that's why he died. Now, you go sleepy sleep. I promise you won't die, baby. I'll give you a kiss when I get home, okay? I love you, honey. Bye-bye.
What happened?
Oh. Bob told Christopher and Andrew that dying was like sleeping forever. The big dope. Well, he meant well, but now the boys won't go to sleep. I've got to go home.
Ma, I'll drop you off.
Are you saying that because you want to or you feel you have to?
No, I'm saying that because if I said I told you so, you might hit me.
Well, I might hit you anyway, you smart mouth.
Frank? I can't believe I caught you. Have you been getting my messages? You have. Well, you're not gonna believe this would... Yeah, I'm glad I called too. But what happened to the money I gave you? How much do you need? I guess I could ask for an increase in my credit card. Okay, I'll do it as soon as I get off the phone. So, you won't believe what happened last night. And the wake, oh, the wake itself is a whole nother... Yeah, I'm gonna call. I just want to catch you up first. Well, can I call when I'm done with the credit card company? Okay. Bye. Sure, anything.
You have to let Eddie get his job back. You have to. He doesn't understand why he was fired. He thinks I've done something wrong. never accompanied here before. It's not what I said about the necklace, right? That's not why he was fired, right?
Who said Annie was fired?
The black-haired guy. Your brother. He said tell Eddie he isn't needed here anymore. I did.
And he did this to you?
Oh my God. What's your name again?
Sandy.
Sandy, did Eddie do this to you?
He loved this job. He did. Is there any way he'd get another chance?
I wish Colleen were here. She'd know what to do.
Can I get you something? Some lasagna, maybe?
All I want is for Eddie to get his job back.
Well, I don't know if I could do that. I mean, I could try, but I don't even think we own the place anymore.
Then who can I talk to? It's important he gets this job back. I can't go back there, not until I tell him he got his job back.
You can't go back there, period. Look what he did to you.
I knew I should have waited for him to be in a better mood.
Sandy, it can't be you deserve this.
I'm not saying that. I just should have knew better, you know?
No, I don't. Listen, you're a beautiful young woman with a beautiful little baby girl here.
Her name is Gabriella.
You deserve someone who treats you with respect. You shouldn't settle for less.
What if I can't find nobody better? How am I going to take care of Gabriella?
Do you have any relatives?
Yeah, but the ones I got, they just aren't an option, you know? I did have this one Aunt Amelia when I was younger. She was really nice. And pretty?
Boy.
But she lives in Ireland now. Raises horses. I think about her sometimes. I bet Gabriella would like horses. But Ireland's so far away.
We'll figure something out. All I know is you can't go back there. No way.
Wow, that's some ring you have there. Like the size of that, huh?
This? Well, actually, me and my fiancé are kind of going halfsies on it, more or less. I mean, he didn't have the money, but he didn't want me to go without, so I'm pitching in. Tell you the truth, he's pitching in.
Well, I guess the ring doesn't matter that much. It must be good having someone around, especially in a rough time like this.
Must be. Colleen and Jack and everybody, they don't know Frank like I do. We shared so much. No one they'll ever meet, no one knew. They'll never know what my mother looked like on Thanksgiving morning, running around her good apron and high heels. And they'll never meet my father and see how he fed the cats in the alley and called them after Johnny Cash songs.
I know what you mean, Eddie and me. We have a history too. We both flunked biology twice.
Sharing a history is one thing, but you gotta stay away from him. He's no good for you. Promise me.
You think you'd be able to start over?
I don't know. If I didn't have to do it alone, I guess. Hey, why don't you stay here a while until we figure out what to do next?
Would that be okay?
Better than okay. I want you to stay.
Wow. You seem really nice. When I met you before, you didn't seem so nice. Now you seem different. Hey, weren't you making a phone call when I interrupted?
Yeah.
I feel bad. You stopped because you were helping me.
Don't worry. Not finishing. Help me too.
I came down here for some peace and quiet. Do you know that Teresa is upstairs having a pajama party? You figured she'd have more sense than that and have people over the day before she buries her father. I have no idea what they're doing, but at one point I swear I heard a baby crying. Hey, have you seen Colleen? I need to get Daddy's doctor's names and addresses. This way I can get documentation of his incompetency last week. The sooner I get that kind of stuff, the better. TJ, stop. TJ! TJ! What gives? I told you that I came down here for peace and quiet. I've been so busy working on this case, I haven't even had time to think about what I'm going to say in the eulogy. Where are you going? I'm talking to you, and you just leave? We're in the middle of a conversation, and you just decide to go. I told you I still have to write the eulogy. Fine, if you want to play that game. But I don't want to hear you bitching that I didn't ask you for your input. I told you!
told myself I wasn't going to speak to you anymore. But you were trying to talk to me. You were talking at me. I haven't said a word since you came in here. You didn't even notice. A conversation? A conversation means listening as well as talking. You don't know how to listen. And the eulogy. Any eulogy you give is not going to be a tribute to Daddy. It's going to be a tribute to you. Like everything else that comes out of your mouth. If you really want my input, I'll give it to you. I'll give it to you, all right? Don't give one. Don't give a eulogy. That's my input.
Sorry, TJ. I didn't realize you were drunk.
Oh, God. You really think I'm drunk just because I don't want to see you getting up there spreading your warped perception of Daddy to people who knew him better than you did?
You're the one with the warped perception, TJ. And just because I don't plan on following him down his road of self-destruction doesn't mean that I didn't know him.
Do you really think you knew him? When was the last time you had a conversation with him, Jack? How what, not since he took your lover away, huh?
What is that? Is that your new toy? Are you going to throw that in my face every time you're at a loss for words?
Oh, you want everyone to believe you cut him off for noble reasons because he broke Mommy's heart or embarrassed the family. But your reasons were completely selfish, Jack, weren't they? They always are. Tell me something, Jack. Why is it you want to run for office? Is it to serve the public or to serve Jack Sweeney?
At least I am doing something with my life. You ought to be ashamed of yourself. You're wasting your potential, you know that?
No, I'm doing what I want to do. That's not a waste. A waste is doing what someone else wants you to do, like what you do.
You are crazy. I don't answer to anyone.
You sure as hell did at one point, Jack. I know all about it. You can't pretend anymore. You wanted to drop out of college, too. Play the piano. But Debbie, of all people? But Daddy told you you'd be wasting your potential. Funny. That's the same thing you tell me, Jack, isn't it? You know, it's pathetic that I have to read about it from my dead father, rather than hearing about it from my living brother. You know, before you give any eulogy, take a look at this. Maybe you'll learn something about him the way I had to learn about you. By the way, Jack, the conversation is over. Good night.
Police escort this time?
I never wanted to hurt anyone, Jack, especially you.
Cut the BS. Why are you here anyway? Let me guess, you need the last 36 cents in the cash register, huh? $20,000, not enough for you, huh?
I didn't take that money. I know you don't believe me, but I didn't.
The last time I believed you, I ended up a fool.
Turning you away was the hardest thing that I've ever had to do.
I didn't see anybody twisting your arm. Why are you here? Charlie already let us know the happy news.
I didn't want you to find out like that. Jack, I know you. You already have someone knocking on a judge's door, trying to get my arrest warrant signed. But I came here to tell you that it's not necessary.
Oh, right, hell it isn't.
Let me finish. The signing of the deed, that was all Charlie's doing. I wanted nothing to do with it. I'm not saying he committed a crime or anything. But what I'm saying is the bar, Jack, I want you to have it. I have the deed here. And whatever we have to do to sign it, to make it all legal.
Just like that.
You're the lawyer. Tell me what I need to do.
All right. I need you to sign here and here.
One thing before I do.
I knew it. You are so full of it.
Jack, there's one thing I want to make clear. The bar, it's yours. I want you to have it. But the marriage, you're not going to pursue that, are you? I'm not saying that it wasn't legal. And marrying Tim was important for reasons that I can't explain. So you'll let me have that?
I just want to get this all straight here. I let you stay married on paper to a dead guy. And then you'll sign over the rights to the bar and everything else.
That's what I'm saying.
Well, how do you know I'm not going to pursue charges in the morning anyway?
I trust you.
Oh, cut the crap. Tell me, Debbie, what's in this for you?
Okay, Jack. Yeah. If you're that suspicious, there's a blank witness line on the marriage certificate.
So now you expect me to go...
If you sign it, then you wouldn't be able to pursue the forgery charge.
You want me to go into cahoots with you?
Jack, if getting the bar back isn't important to you.
Fine, but you sign first.
So. Guess that's it.
Our final order of business.
It was really good hearing you play again.
I haven't played in so long, and my fingers
are... You sounded so good.
Look, I have a lot of work to do around here. And...
Yeah, I guess I should be going too. Oh, Jack? One thing before I go. Do you think I can have a copy of Tim's death certificate?
Yeah, I guess so. I got a couple of extras.
Great. It takes like 10 weeks to get one from the state.
All right, now how would you know that?
I heard.
Oh, you're good. Oh, I like that one. You sounded so good playing the piano again. You almost had me fooled again.
What?
Why would you want a copy of the death certificate?
As a memento.
If you want it, tell me why.
You know that I'm sentimental. I'm keeping a scrapbook.
Tell me why, Debbie. Because you're right, you know. They are at the judge's door right now.
Well, don't you think they should add your name to the warrant? Come on, Jack. You got what you wanted. You got the bar. And don't look at me like that, because I'm not hurting anyone. All right, I'll let you know what's going on. A long time ago, I took out a life insurance policy on Tim, and it was under the condition that we were husband and wife. And I only thought it was going to be a matter of time. And then when his conditions took a turn for the worse, I said, why not? I've been paying on this policy for 8 years. It's not like I was taking anything from anyone. And we've been living together for 10 years, for God's sake. Common law, we were already married.
But this is not a common law state. And the groom was in a coma.
Well, Jack, according to my paperwork, I would say, don't go getting all high and mighty on me.
When I signed that, it was to ensure that this bar got into the hands of its rightful owners. But this is different. This is a crime.
Come on, Jack. It might not be right in the legal sense, but I'm not hurting anyone or anything.
A crime is a crime.
Well, what if some good came out of it? What if I made a little contribution to your campaign to help ease your conscience?
You think a measly campaign contribution is going to make me turn a blind eye to the law? I have made a reputation upholding the law.
What if it wasn't so measly?
It makes no difference.
Come on, Jack. We can't pass up an opportunity like this. You know, $1 million, I could think of a lot of ways to make it up to society.
What did you say?
I could think of a lot of ways.
No, no, no. How much money did you just say?
$1 million. And I'll cut you in for half or whatever it takes.
$500,000.
You could sure buy a lot of campaign buttons with that if you still chose to run.
You know, I know a guy who won a Clio, too. I've always wanted him to do a TV spot for me, but I can never afford his prices.
Well, now you could. Whatever you want. You can do it. I know it.
I'd get in for sure. And I have some real ideas, too. Some real changes, real improvements. like this one after-school program for the children where each kid, each one get... I'm sorry. I'm getting all carried away here.
Jack, I haven't seen you this excited since we talked about going on the road together.
Let's not compare this to that, okay? You left me with my bags packed and my chin hanging on the floor.
I'm really sorry, Jack. I don't know if I ever told you that. And what I said earlier about you playing, I really meant it.
I miss it sometimes, too.
We had so much fun together.
The greatest times. Do you remember that time in the East Village?
Biker bar?
Yeah, I can still see it like it was yesterday. That guy, I could swear that he was gonna crack me over the head with that guitar. But you had them bursting into tears.
That song, I really think about it often.
I can still picture it. These big, burly biker beasts bawling like babies. You were wonderful.
Had your secret time, and you had your reasons why. Now you've been set free.
Debbie, why are you doing this to me now? You had your chance with me 11 years ago and you didn't want me.
I did, Jack.
Then why did you dump me? It was your idea to see the world together. We can go night by night, gig to gig, and see everything. You had me convinced that I would learn more by doing that than I would ever learn by staying in school. All the romantic schmaltz in the book, and I bit. And the second I did, you dumped me. We're all wrong for each other, Jack. It'll never work. You should go back to school.
Come on, Jack. If we'd stayed together, you wouldn't be where you are today. You wouldn't be running for Congress, that's for sure.
Who knows? Maybe we'd be doing something even better.
You would have wasted all your potential.
My potential.
I guess it's best things turned out the way Tim planned.
What do you mean, the way Tim planned?
The last thing I wanted was to turn you away.
What did Tim say to you? You're telling me he told you to dump me?
He asked me to.
And you did?
It was what was best for you.
You had me convinced that you were best for me. Why? Tell me why.
It was for your own good.
What could he have said to you to make you want to do this?
He made it worth my while, that's all.
He paid you to dump me?
It wasn't like that. I loved you and I wanted
love.
You.
What kind of love could be bought like that? He wanted you for himself, so he bought you, and you took it. How could you compromise yourself like that for a few measly dollars? You know who does that, Debbie? A whore does that. That's what you are. You're a whore.
How dare you call me that, Jack? When no more than 10 minutes ago you were willing to put everything you've ever stood for on the line? You're the whore, Jack! At least what Tim and I did. We did because we wanted what was best for you. If you find that so hard to believe, that's because you've never done anything for anyone in your entire life. Tim had his faults, and nobody knows that better than me. But faults and all, Jack, you're not half the man your father was. And you know what? You were too busy being so angry to notice that. You could have learned a lot from him about how to treat people. But you know what, Jack? It's too late for that. It's too late.
Diapers and formula.
Your fiancé did this to you?
He was upset about losing his job.
He hit you because of what I say?
I ain't blaming you if that's what you think. How would you know he would take it so badly?
How would I know when I didn't give him? Look, you can't go back there. Here. This should cover whatever supplies you need.
I can't take it.
Well, please, you have to. I feel responsible. I was always so quick to want to unload this place that, well, I didn't think about what was good for anyone else. Here. Maybe you can get him a rattle or something.
You sure?
Of course. This? We got this for Daddy on one Father's Day. I remember because that was the year that I wanted to get him a stack of baseball cards, you know, because I figured he'd give them right back to me. But you insisted.
Jack, are you feeling all right?
Never better.
Have you been to sleep at all?
I don't know. What time is it?
It's almost time for the funeral. Oh my goodness, you haven't had any sleep. Maybe you better not speak to those reporters.
The reporters are outside?
Jack, yes. And there's more now than before, and that guy Bax is out there with his video camera. What are you gonna say to them?
I don't know. Let's invite him in for a drink.
Oh, you really start to scare me. I'll get it. Hello? Oh, hi, Frank. Of course she's here. Where do you think she'd be on the day she buries her father? At a Mets game? Teresa! Phone! I probably should have hung up on him. But from now on, I'm minding my own business. You people can run your own lives.
Who is it?
Who do you think?
Frank? I know I said I'd make the phone call, but are you finished yelling? Are you finished? Listen, I decided not to make the phone call. I decided some other things, too. It's over, Frank. I'm not marrying you. You're alone now, like I've been since I've known you. And I give you back the ring, but since I paid for it, I'm keeping it. Goodbye, Frank.
Wow!
What has gotten into this family?
I don't know. I feel like Mommy and Daddy are giving me the spirit to move on with my life. Is that weird?
Well, that's too weird. I said the same thing to Bob this morning. We decided to go for the house.
Oh, that's great. Do you mind if I come visit all the time?
Are you kidding? I'd love it.
You know, that's a great outfit. I have the earrings just to go with it. You want to come see them?
Okay, I'd love to. On the way out this morning, I did rip two pair of pantyhose. They tripped on the kids' toys and were quiet downstairs.
Christ, they're like animals out there. I swear to God. And that guy Baxter, what a clown. What a moron. You know what he done to me? He stuck his camera right in my face. Knocked my hat right off of my head. 16 years I've had this hat. It'll never be the same again. Hey, that's a nice looking cap. You think a cap like that would look good in a head like mine?
Easy there, Elbow. This cap stays right where my father left it. You think 16 years is good age for a cap? This one must be more at 60.
60 years old. That's some age for a cap.
Yeah, and it's got a great story, too. Why don't you join me for a drink and I'll tell you all about it.
I couldn't do that. It's too early in the morning. Sure, I'm on my way to church.
Am I hearing this right? Is Elbow Bender refusing to have a drink with Tim Sweeney's oldest son? What kind of an insult is that?
I suppose you're right. But first things first, as I promised, I have a little something for you. That's the money I owe your father.
You have it?
Didn't I tell you I would? Oi, 16 years. They don't make him like this anymore.
It's a great story with that cap, too. It was my grandfather's. He died when my father was 5. The way I understand it, it was a fishing accident. A storm came out of nowhere, and, well, now that I think about it, the man must have known he only had about 2 minutes left to live. You know what he did? He tied this cap to the boat.
That's a nice cap, but I don't think I'd go that far.
It wasn't for the cap's sake, Elbow. At least my father didn't think so. He did it so we'd have something to remember him by. You want to know why? Because whenever my grandfather would come in from fishing or cutting the turf, my father would run up and jump in his arms, and grandfather would throw this cap over his head, cover his eyes, and say, "Where is Moses when the lights went out?"
Everyone knows the answer to that one, in the dark.
That's right. And my father would say, "In the dark, Pa, in the dark." And grandfather would answer, "And don't ever let that happen to you, boyo."
He told you that?
I don't know. He might have. But he wrote it all down in these journals here. He was a lot more interesting than I ever gave him credit for, my father.
Are we toasting his honor or what?
You go ahead.
I cannot join him.
I haven't touched a drop in over 10 years.
Ah, Jesus, what kind of an insult is that? Tim Sweeney's own son refusing to have a drink in his honor.
Well, I guess you've made your point, Elbow. To Tim Sweeney, as we know him, as we will continue to get to know him.
May he rest this day in heavenly peace. And if that's not possible, may he have a good time in hell shaking hands with all his friends.
What's wrong with this picture?
Nothing wrong with the guy having a little conversation with his father's friend, is there, TJ?
Ah, now there's a nice young lad. Would you mind to join us?
No, thanks, Elbow. Next time. It's a little too early, even for me.
Ah, good enough, then. Good enough.
Oh, thank goodness you're all still here. I got a call from the limousine driver. Charlie commandeered the limo and is on his way here. The driver said he was in a terrible rage. I don't know what this is all about, but I don't think it's safe for you to be here. Does anyone know there's a crowd of reporters outside?
There is. There is.
Why would Charlie be in a rage? He was fine last night.
Yeah, after Jack got through schmoozing him.
So why are we all standing around? Somebody get Ellen a drink. Ellen, I'm so happy that you were here. I heard this really corny joke. Now let me see if I can remember the punchline.
I appreciate the hospitality, Jack, but I don't think this is the appropriate time to be telling jokes.
That's right, Jack. Charlie could have a gun.
You don't think he'd be crazy enough to shoot anyone, do you?
I don't know. I heard when he doesn't feel like walking his dog, he takes it into the backyard and shoots it.
I think you're so smart, do you? Get up. Think you're smart, do you? You want to figure a way to get this bar back. But you're going down any way, Sweeney. You think you're such hot stuff with all those reporters out there you're trying to impress. What are they going to write about when I drag you out of here in handcuffs? There ain't a voter in his right mind going to forget that come election day.
Charlie, what are you talking about? You cannot arrest us. We own this bar. We're not breaking and entering. You don't have a leg to stand on.
What? No leg to stand on? How about I stand on your skull?
Charlie!
He's no good, Debbie. He deserves this.
Take those cuffs off him now.
What?
Now.
All right. But he's only going to go out there and suck up to those reporters like he's Mr. Politician here.
If he wants to, let him. That's what Tim would have wanted.
Fine, but I'm not done with it.
Oh, yes, you are. And so am I. What Jack does with his life is up to him. It's none of our business. And the marriage? Oh. Tim wanted to marry me, he would have, but he didn't. I could have found a way to live with all that money, but you know what? I'd rather live with my conscience. And I wish you as much luck in your life, Jack. Goodbye. Come on, Charlie.
No bar, no money either.
What was that about?
It's a long story.
If it's a long story, perhaps you better save it for later. Father Rafferty's still a bit edgy after last night. I don't want him to think he's being stood up.
Was that just last night?
Oh, so much has happened.
I don't mean to be pushy, but if we plan on making the prayer service before they close the coffin.
You know what? You guys go ahead. I'm going to stay back and get cleaned up.
Well, the bathroom's free, so you better not be late.
Yeah, you have a campaign speech. How many eulogy to give?
I wanted to talk to you about that, TJ. I don't think I'm going to give the eulogy.
You're not?
I think you should.
Me?
Yeah.
I think Daddy would like that.
You knew him better than all of us.
But I wouldn't know what to say.
Sure you would. Come on, tell about how he had to walk 6 miles to school in the bare feet. Or how this cap was the only thing his father left him. In contrast to that, TJ, talk about all the great things that he did for you. All the great things he did for us. Leaving us the music, the memories.
The corny jokes.
Yeah, I guess I could do that.
I know you can, little brother. You've got a lot of potential. Now get out of here so I can go get cleaned up.
If we shorten the prayer service, we might make it to the church on time.
Didn't Mommy always say Daddy'd be late for his own wake?
Elmo.
Huh?
You're still here.
While I was just hanging around, I thought you might lose this in the confusion.
Elmo, I meant what I said. Keep the money.
I meant what I said, too. Now, look here. I went to a lot of trouble to get this money. I sold my lunch wagon, in fact, my livelihood, and I won't take no for an answer.
You sold your lunch wagon?
Of course. How'd
the hell do you think I could come up with $20,000 in such a short notice?
$20,000.
Sure. That's the money your father loaned me a month ago. Boy, was I in a hell of a jam. That loan shark couldn't be sweet-talked any longer. Ah, but that's all behind me now, thank God. Your father made me promise I'd give it up before he gave me the money. I'm better off, I tell you, better off.
Well, how are you going to survive without your lunch wagon?
I'll do all right. Somebody'd be crazy enough to offer me a job.
My noble, you need the money more than I do. Please, keep it.
I will not keep it. I'd rather burn it than keep it.
You know what? I think I know someone who needs it more than both of us.
Jack, there's a crowd of reporters outside. Should I let them in?
No, leave them. I'll deal with them in a second. But first, there's something I want you to have.
What is it?
$20,000. That's what it is.
That's a lot of money. I can't take it.
Yes, you can. For the baby's sake. This way you can make a new start and get away from Eddie. Far away.
Hmm. With that money, I could go to Ireland. I didn't even have plans for that. Are you sure?
Positive. Under two conditions. One, you agree never to see Eddie again.
Sure thing.
And two, my friend Elbow here agrees to work at Sweeney's place, teaching me everything my father knew about serving the needs of others.
Huh, sure, I'd love it.
Great. Then we have a deal.
Thank you. I don't mean to be rude, but I would like to make it to Tim's funeral.
Of course, go right ahead.
Hey, wait a minute. I'm heading over that way myself. Do you mind if I go with you? You want me to chase away these reporters from outside?
I'll deal with them, Elbo, thank you.
16 years I've had this hat. It'll never be the same.
Announced my candidacy for the congressional seat being left vacated by Congressman Hadley. As many of you also know, on that same day my father died. Nothing would give him greater pleasure than to know I was running for political office, and it would be a great honor for me to dedicate it to his memory, but I can't do that. You see, in coming to terms with his death, I had to face certain facts about his life and certain facts about my own life. And while I realize I still have a lot of reckoning to do, there's a lot I need to learn about serving the needs of others. Well, both in my private life and publicly. And it's with that I have to withdraw my candidacy for the race. Now, if you'll excuse me, I am long overdue in paying respects to my father. Take a chance to thank a couple of key people, our lighting and sound, Joe Pagonia, who I hope I didn't put some names too bad, and the goddess herself, Della Doherty, who wrote, directed, produced, put it all together. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.